According to the report of the General Staff of Ukraine, the Ukrainian Army has successfully continued counteroffensive operations on the Melitopol and Bakhmut fronts in the last 24 hours. Russian President Vladimir Putin held a meeting with Andrei Troshev, former commander of Wagner. During the meeting, they discussed the use of volunteer combat units in the Ukrainian war. Kremlin spokesman Dmitry Peskov described Armenia's move to ratify the Rome Statute as extremely hostile. NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg stated that Ukrainian forces are making progress and gave Kiev a message of continued support. Ukraine is now closer to NATO than ever before, Stoltenberg said. Mikhail Podolyak, advisor to the presidential office, said that temporarily occupied Crimea is gradually coming under fire control by Ukraine. He emphasized that it is a strategic task of Ukrainian forces to cut off the direction of support to the Russian occupation group. A Ukrainian drone dropped explosives on a substation in a Russian village near the border in the Kursk region, cutting electricity to a hospital, Russia's regional governor said. Hungarian Prime Minister Viktor Orban said that very difficult questions must be answered before the European Union can start full membership negotiations with Ukraine.